Say, Father, thank you for your word. We hear it. We believe it. That we may be a doer of it. Thank you for all you are doing. All you are. We decrease. You increase. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord is releasing a mighty outpouring of His Spirit, and is that we've been hearing all year long is the year of release. And He's watering. I saw this rain that He's bringing to water. To water many, many seeds. And not only it's going to be a season that you're going to start seeing the word manifested in and through you, but it's also going to be a season that even the word is also going to be tested. And I believe that the Lord has prepared us for many tests from glory to glory. Amen. Someone asked me last week, well, do you believe that God is doing this to test me? And that person was going through a great trial. And I said, well, God doesn't tempt us with evil. That's what James says. I said, God has removed through the cross sickness and disease and hurts and pain. He has conquered death, so He's not going to put anything bad on you to teach you anything. Everything that He does in your life is to bring you to the saving knowledge of who He is, of everything that He has done on the cross, so that then you can receive it, you can be a doer of it, you can release it unto others. God doesn't do evil in your life to teach you good. So when we talk about testing, when I talk about testing, I want to kind of tell you what I mean. In connection to the water, because this is also the season of the sword of the Lord. Amen? So turn your Bible in Isaiah, your Bible, your Bible. Whew, I love it when I see rain. I often see the Holy Spirit as fire. I see Him as the wind. But every time I see Him as the rain, it's always because of an increase. Because some plant, some water, but God give the increase. And there's seasons in our lives from glory to glory that there's words that He has placed in us, that He waters to cause those truths to be heard, revealed, manifested to another level. Words that He has spoken unto you, words that He has spoken through His word. The word that's tested is the word that is tested. Oh. So in Isaiah 55, familiar passage. I'll read at verse 8. It says, for my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so my ways are higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Then He says, for as the rain comes down and the snow from heaven, and do not return there, but water the earth and make it bring forth and bud, not Budweiser. Making sure you're reading. that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it. There's the rain that falls down on the earth, and then through the precipitation, it waters the ground. And then there's the heat of the sun, and then it causes it to rise. You remember? Amen? Then there's clouds that are formed as the air cools it, and then it goes back up, and then the cycle, of the water goes forth again. And he says, just as the rain, just like the cycle of the water, so is the cycle of my word. And it says, it will not return to me void. In other words, what I speak forth, last week we saw that his word is anointed, that Jesus would speak a thing, and with what he speaks forth, there's manifestation of what he brings, whether it's for healing, freedom, whatever it is, that there's a manifestation because the word is anointed. But what happened when you go through seasons in your life that it's like Joseph, who had received a dream and he had gone through the season and he had heard the voice of the Lord. He knew what God wanted him to do, what his plan was. But then he went through a season of testings. And we read in Psalm 105 how it says, until the word, well, let's look at it. Somebody looked at me like, where? Psalm 105. Whoo! We're about to see some things come out of the ground. Some things that have been planted that are going to be watered quickly, including people, not just when I say things, you know, when we think of seed, we often see think about money because of the way we've been trained in the church. But seeds of love, seeds of peace, seeds of joy, seeds that comes from the word of God, seeds of life. So it says in 105 of Psalm, it says, well, let's start at verse 17. And he sent a man before them, Joseph, who was sold as a slave. They hurt his feet with fetters. He was laid in irons until the time that his word came to pass. The word of the Lord tested him. The word of the Lord tested him. In other words, sometimes you go through things and you wonder if the word that you know the word speaks, whether it's meeting your need or working in your marriage, in your health, whatever it is, you wonder if really you should continue to believe it because things do not come to pass. And the enemy comes in to get people to believe that they're the one that is tested. But it's your faith. It's the trial of your faith. It's the word that is tested. And I love that. Because the sower sows the word. And if the sower sows the word and is watching over it, then when the word is tested, I know that my God, the sower himself, is going to make sure that the word does not return to him void. God is raising up an army that's going to believe in the word, stand on the word, speak the word, be a doer of the word, release the word of God, believe the word of God, regardless of anything that they might go through. It will not matter what they go through because they will believe. The trial of your faith. So when you see that his word does not return to him void, then you wonder then why in the parable of the sower in Mark chapter 4, we read, whoo, my God. You know, it's like some people that you have spoken the word over or you shared the gospel and you think that nothing is happening. You prayed healing for people and you think they're not being healed. You've been believing and standing for your family, but nothing seems to happen. Do you know that when those things happen, it's because your faith is growing to such a point that God is not worrying, God is not wondering, God knows, oh, wait a minute, he's putting everything in place, and he's like, oh, no. The battle is coming against me because it's my word that's being tested. And he watches it, and we read in Peter how the fiery trials and things that comes against us, it's bringing forth a manifestation of the, I can't never pronounce that word, the real thing. The real thing. It's the real thing. The real thing of your faith. If you do not go through any trials, how will people, including yourself, will know that God himself has given you the faith to walk through it? If we never go through anything, we will not know. So the enemy and life, circumstances, whatever, there's a whole bunch of things that happens. But God is not concerned. God is so awesome. God doesn't see anything without already knowing the answer to a situation. God doesn't see you in need and wonder, how am I going to meet that need? No, God meets all your needs according to his riches. He doesn't do it according to what you think he can do. He doesn't do it according to how much money you have or your parents have or your bank account have or how much is left on your gold card. He doesn't do it based on that. He said, no, it's not according to your riches. It's according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. So, but you're standing on the word and you go through things and you wonder, God, what are you doing? And I believe that this is going to be a season between now and even until the end of this year as we go forth. You remember he said the manifestation of his word, that things are going to be watered and that some words that you've been waiting for the manifestation of are coming to manifestation. And we are on a place of testing that doesn't sound fun sometimes when you're waiting for something. I remember when I used to go through testings in school, I didn't like tests. Because no matter what you would prepare for, whatever the test was about was different. I would always wonder, why didn't they tell me to study that? I spent all my time learning all that by heart. I know all of them. And then I get there to the test and I'm thinking, what? This is not fair. And with God, sometimes it's a little bit like this. You think that the test is in one area, but in fact, it's in another. God will always test the things that he already knows just to for you to know what the test is about. God already knows the answer. He's not testing you like he doesn't know what you're made of. He wants you to know what you're made of. You're made of him. You're not made in China. Everything is made in China. We were talking about that earlier. Everything is made in China. We made in heaven. Our citizenship is in heaven. We have a label. We have the seal of the Spirit that says made in heaven. But when trials happen in your life, you don't know if really you should continue to believe or not. So here comes the parable of the sower. And in chapter 4 of Mark, it says, "And again he began to teach by the sea, and a great multitude was gathered to him, so that he got into a boat and sat in it on the sea. And the whole multitude was on the land facing the sea. Then he taught them many things by parables, and he said to them in his teaching, 'Listen, behold, a sower went out to sow. And it happened as he sowed that some seed fell by the wayside, and the birds of the air came and devoured it. Whew. Jeez. Devoured it. In other words, it's the people with a hard heart, it's the people, you know, the wayside, it's the soil. And people hear the word, but they think it's for the birds, so the birds come eat it. No, it's a joke. It's a joke. And some fell on stony ground where it did not have much earth, and immediately it sprang up because it had no depth of earth, no root. People get born again, they're so happy, and they put a license plate with Jesus on it, and they're so happy, hoo, 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 hoo. But there's no depth. There's no depth. So then it talks about, but when the sun was up, it was scorched, and because it had no root, it withered away. And some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it, and it yielded no crop. Rocky road ice cream. No, rocky ground. But other seed fell on good ground and yielded a crop that sprang up, increased, and produced some 30-fold, some 60, and some 100. And he said to them, "He who has ears to hear, let him hear." Well, my question to you is, Isaiah says that his word does not return void. And here in this parable, you see some seed, the word, the sower, so the word that appeared to be lost. Some on the wayside. Some on the soil that doesn't have any depth. Some on the soil that's being choked by all the thorns around it. When the cares of the world come, it says the riches, the cares of the world, when all these come, it chokes the word. And so my question to the Holy Spirit used to be, when I read that, I said, well, I don't understand, because I believe that your word does not return to you void. So if it doesn't return to you void, how come there's all these seeds? That are being wasted, it appears to me. And the Holy Spirit, he says, well, do you think that's four different kind of people? Do you think you're always good? I said, what do you mean? He said, well, as I take you from glory to glory, one day you could ground based on the word that you receive. Say, but the next day you might be hard-headed about a few things. I give you a truth in one area, you receive it greatly, but there's no root in that area. And then something happened and it just shocks it. So he says, my daughter, I'm bringing every seed. Because you belong to me, and I'm training you because I'm transforming you by the renewing of your mind. Because faith comes by hearing, and hearing comes by the word. The word doesn't come by hearing. Hearing comes by the word. So he says, I am the sower, and I will continue to get the word to you no matter what. When you belong to me, I will bring you a revelation in one area, and if you don't get it one day, it will come back to me, and I will bring it back. And I will do circle until you get it, because I want you to get it, because you're going to be tested on it. And every time I get it to you, it's so that you can be prepared to pass the test. Because if the Lord brings you the word on meeting all of your needs, for example, well, the first time I heard that word, I was born again. But that word didn't go where it's supposed to go. I didn't know about the riches. I didn't know about the glory. I had absolutely no clue. Then another day, I heard it, and I believed it, but then I still couldn't pay my rent. And the cares of the world came. And then I had heard it, but I didn't believe it. Well, wouldn't you know that that word came around? Wouldn't you know it came around again? And again? And again? And again? And again and again and again and again? Because God is so faithful, he wanted me to finally get it, and through the storm, and as I was being tested, questioning the provisions of God, he was preparing the cycle of his word, thinking, my daughter, you are going to believe what I want you to believe. And now when I read that scripture, I'm like, see, a regular seed brings forth 8 times. The harvest is usually 8 times the seed. So when you see 30-fold, and people tell you, especially when they want your money, when people tell you, well, you know, you're only going to get 30-fold. I'm thinking, no, wait a minute. In the natural, I get 8 times. But because I'm a child of God, the minimum is 30. Amen. 30. Because then suddenly there's good ground. Because suddenly the Lord, the Holy Spirit has been plowing and removing this weed and removing the weed. Removing all the stuff. Because I am good fruit. And the Bible says if the fruit is good, everything is good. So then one day then I started getting 30-fold return on that word, you know, and God will supply all of your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Well, I was thinking God will supply all of my needs. The Holy Spirit says, no, read it again. God will supply all of your needs, because Paul now was in the 60-100-fold return. He knew God was going to provide his needs. So now he was teaching other people. So he was watering the word that he himself had believed. Because he was saying, I know God will take care of me no matter what, but I need you to understand, because you're too focused on the giving part. But God wants to give you seeds to be a sower for other people. And then this truth is for everything. Spiritual warfare. The word that says, you know, greater is he who is in you than he who is in the word. So then you have a revelation, you good fruit, there's growth in the areas of provision, but in spiritual warfare, you might go through a season that the enemy is just eating your lunch. And it would appear that that word doesn't bear any fruit. But the seed sows, is sown by the sower. And the sower is Jesus. The word of God. And the word of God, when it is sown, not only it will not return to him void, but he has this way to work through a cycle that's greater than a washing machine. He'll allow you to go through a spin cycle just so that when you get out the next time you have a need, you will be so strong, people will wonder, well, didn't you go through this last month? What happened to you between last month and now that it looks to me like you're able to handle it a different way? Yes, the Holy Spirit's been watering the word. I am passing the test with flying colors. And then you get used to one test and you think, I've aced that. You think, I'm so mature now. I wish other people will finally get it like I get it. I don't know what's going to take them that long. And the Holy Spirit is like, no. If you think you got it, you haven't got anything yet as you should get, because my thoughts are higher than yours. My ways are not the same. And the things that I'm trying to teach you, you will always, from glory to glory, be able to reach it another way. Because I want you to be able to be a seed sower yourself.
Yeah.
I'm training you to go in all the world and plant seeds and water them. But if you don't go through the process of believing it for yourself, when you try to sow it in somebody else's life, they won't believe it, because you will say it from your head, not from your heart. So I'm going to plow, I'm going to do whatever I need to do until it comes out from your heart. So I heard, greater is he who is in me than he who is in the world. It meant absolutely nothing to me. And the person that gave me that scripture 20 years ago, you know, she did it like I was supposed to get it. Greater is he who is in you than he who is in the world. Okay. Have you been there?
Yeah.
To me, I didn't feel anything great in me. I felt unworthy. I didn't feel anything. You know, the Holy Spirit was just working in me. I just got born again, and I was seeing all the other people in church being so perfect, and I was dealing with all this stuff. Didn't mean anything to me. But one day, I didn't get up one day and said, hey, today is the day I'm really going to get that scripture. You have to see God in your life. You belong to God. You are his property. He knows how to bring forth things to you, because there's nothing like a revelation of his word. There's nothing like you believing a truth. You know, you as a Christian, we've been tested in three major areas. First is the truth. He's being tested, so you have to know the truth. You go through a test of love. Because that's what makes you a Christian. The way that you love one another. So that's the great one, I think the greatest test of all is the test of love. Because you will encounter people who don't love you. They don't agree with you. It's something spiritual, the love of God. It's not something that you can reason with your head. But when you pass the test, then there's an increase of the compassion that comes through you and the love for other people, regardless whether they think like you, believe like you, whatever they think. That's not about that. So there's different areas you see that you're being tested constantly. The parable of the sower is the sower that's trying to get the seed to you in different areas until you are being transformed because your mind is renewed. And then you can test. You can prove what is the good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. Amen? So, one day, I got it. I thought, oh yes, Lord, greater is Christ who is in the world. That was my 30-fold return or something. Because the Holy Spirit, he spanked me about a year after. Because the cycle, it came around again. And then I read it again, and that time, the way that he was bringing it is, greater is he who is in you. I was like, I couldn't understand, greater is he than he who is in the world. But no, greater he who is in you than he who is in the world. And I was like, wait a minute. Because I'm telling you that, you know, you hear the word through different ways, but never forget that it's the Holy Spirit who is teaching it to you. Yeah. Never forget that it's the sower that's bringing it to you. So when you get a revelation of something, you have to get a hold of it and believe and be able to say, oh my God, if you show me that, that means that you are bringing me to a passing of the test in that area. That means if the enemy comes at me the next time, I will have been prepared for the test that I can tell the devil straight at him and say, oh no, devil, greater is he who is in me than he who is in the world. Yeah. Whoo! Yeah. My God. Because we're talking about the sword of the Spirit. So to the level that the test is being passed is to the level that when you release it, it's like, don't sling, boom, slack. And people wonder. People wonder. And we can't really train people to do that because it's the training of the Holy Spirit. Because that Jesus, it says in the parable, take heed. He who hears. We have to pay attention. We get so busy sometimes that the sower sends a seed on a Sunday morning or like tonight, and that suddenly you're like, oh yeah. But then remember, the enemy is waiting outside the door trying to snatch it. And even though God brings it again, I don't want to waste any time. Precious Lord, don't let it be another year, whatever the cycle goes through. Help me be so quick to hear. Help us pay attention how we receive the word. Because each of us, even tonight, each of us, we're hearing this word a different way. And the Lord is so faithful that he brings life and increase on the word based on whatever we need, each and every one of us. And it's not the one who gets 100-fold that's greater than the one that gets 30. Because it's in different areas, you understand? So take heed, he who think he stands, lest he falls. The moment that you think, well, you know, I know that, oh, I heard that again last year. Well, last year around Thanksgiving, we went through that scripture that in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God for you. I heard it every year. Here we go again, Thanksgiving. I'm pretty sure we're going to go through the same scripture. I think I have a turkey to cook that weekend. I don't really need to go to church. I already know that one. That's when the greatest revelation comes, that the Holy Spirit is, no, there is nothing that you know as you think you know it. It's the scripture says, he who thinks he knows anything knows nothing yet as he ought to know. But the one who is loved by God, the one who loves God, he says this one is known by God. Wow. It doesn't matter what you know as long as you are known by God. And you are known by God when you humble yourself and you remain teachable. What are the depths the Holy Spirit is going to water through this word, this Thanksgiving? Maybe he's going to bring light on the in everything. Maybe he's going to shine the light on everything, what that means. Then maybe it's going to be shining the light on the word give. Give thanks. Maybe it's going to be on this is the will of God. Maybe it's going to be in Christ. Maybe it's going to be for you. I don't know. But that scripture, greater is he who is in me than he who is in the world. I got so many times I heard like a light on part of the word. Then one day it was on greater, like he says, no, he says, you have to understand, greater is not a little bit greater. It says there's no comparison. It's greater. Greater. And he says, not you. You're not great. Each word, the Holy Spirit, everything that the sower sows in your life, you can expect that it's because he's taking you to another level of being able to manifest that truth all around you. You're in a test right now in one area or another. Your faith is being tested right now. And we might not even know that we're being tested. We think nothing is happening. But take heed what you just heard last week. Sometimes we ask the Lord, give me a word. Give me a word. Lord, why don't you sow something on me? You're the sower. I need a word now, tonight. Father, if you don't give me a word tonight. And the Holy Spirit is like, I'm watering the word I gave you 2 weeks ago. Did you already forget what I told you 2 weeks ago, last week, yesterday? The Lord says it's not him giving you words. He wants you to be a doer of the word, to hear the word, and be able to know that you're walking through the test of that word. So tonight, the Holy Spirit is giving you an A+, because there's one area that all of us are passing a test. There might be some areas where we're going through one, a word, a revelation, but I tell you that the truth is that you're also passing it. The testimonies we hear, they're passing through the test. The way that you hear tonight on your crutches, you should be home. But your faith could let you stay at home. The way that you've been standing for your son. So the situation might still be the same. You understand? Some situation, they still remain the same. But you have changed because you've been watered. And you're able to walk through it with more fire and more confidence than ever before because you have passed the test. So there's some tests we don't know, we've never seen before. We don't know what the answer is, but from glory to glory, there's some other tests we start recognizing and think, oh, I know that one. I know that one. Which one do you know tonight? Greater is he. And then you can start singing, you know, different words. That's how you memorize the scripture. Greater is he who is in me than he who is in the world. Now you want to have the revelation of greater. Is he who is in me? Is that the way you teach the children, Sandy? Well, we need adult classes. But we can do that and memorize scriptures. Because to me, you could memorize a scripture in your head, but when you memorize it in your heart, it changes everything. Because it's your heart that memorizes it. So tonight, be of good cheer, because Joseph, when the time came that the word was tested, the kings, the people that were after Joseph, did a total turnaround, 360 degrees, and helped him. And all the time that Joseph went through trial, remember his story, how he grew in favor. You're thinking, how did he grow in favor? All these things happening to him. What do you mean he grew in favor? No, every time something was happening to him and he got lied about and he was put in jail and the butler forgot him and on and on and on, he was growing. What was growing? The word was growing. When Paul was in jail, and you see him write all those letters, everything that he went through, he writes all these to distribute what he had learned to us. So he writes, rejoice. Then he thinks, oh, I better give them a double shower of rain on that one. Again, I say to you, rejoice. And it's beautiful when you start reading the Bible that you've been doing and you start making a journal. Make a journal on the drops. Write down the drops. Don't let any drops pass by. Every time you read and you see something that, whoa, write it down. Oh, hallelujah. When one drop of rain falls, it can easily just touch your hand and just drop to nothing. But now when there's more than one drop and it starts raining, oh, then it starts being in a way that it touches your hand, your body. It starts watering you. The Holy Spirit, he wants tonight, he wants to release an incredible watering over you. The same way that you have seeds, you are a seed in the world. You've been planted for the kingdom. You are a seed. The Holy Spirit wants to water you. He wants to completely just saturate you. Oh, precious, precious, precious living word. Amen. Stand to your feet. If I could sing, we could sing, rain on me, but we don't have to sing it. We can ask him, lift up your hands and say, Lord, here I am. Rain on me. Water your word. Plant your word. I hunger for your word. Just one word. Filled with your life. I receive abundance of rain. Thank you, Lord. I'm passing the test in that one area. But you know about the other, Lord. I need a word. I need you to water it. Anoint my ears to hear. My heart to receive. I believe. Help my unbelief. Thank you, Father. You're watching over your word to perform it. Go ahead. Have it done. I receive it all. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let it.